In this video, I'm gonna show you how to use the tracker inside DaVinci Resolve. So let's get right into it. So I'm already inside Fusion, and I've got this aerial footage of this lovely city. Let's take a look at it. And it's perfect for the point tracker or simply tracker. So first of all, we're gonna hit Shift Spacebar on the keyboard and then type in TRA. We're gonna add it to the node tree and we're gonna connect it right after our media one. We can do that by dragging it right here, then hitting Shift on the keyboard, and once this arrow gets blue, we can drop it. And as you can see, we've got many properties here on the right, and we'll get to that in a minute. Before that, let's check out our tracker on the screen. So let's zoom in. And as you can see, this tracker is made of two rectangles, a small one and a dashed one. The small one is the actual area we want to track, and the larger one is the area where our tracker will look for the object every time a frame changes. Let me show you. So if we want to track this point right here, all we have to do is drag our tracker to this point, and it automatically zooms in so we can see better. We drop it, we can adjust the size of our rectangle, like this. And to know at what size you should leave your dashed rectangle, it's important to know how much your object moves from frame to frame. The more it moves, the larger your rectangle should be. In our case here, this object moves very slowly, so there's no reason to leave a large search area. We can make it very small, like this is fine. Okay, once we established our tracking point, it's time to go through the properties. So here on trackers is, well, where we control our trackers. And you can add as many trackers as you want. All you have to do is click on this button right here, Add, and it will appear on the screen. But for this simple motion, we don't need more than one. Here, we have 5 buttons, the track reverse, and this button will track from the end of the footage to the beginning. We've got the track reverse from current time, meaning that if we start tracking in the middle of the footage, it will only track from this point all the way to the beginning. And if we hit this button, track forward from current time, it will track from this point to the end of the footage. And if we hit track forward, it'll track from the beginning to the end. Okay, let's go back. Here we have frames per point, and this is by default set to 1. And it means that at every frame, the tracker will add a motion point. If we set it to 2, the tracker will do it every 2 frames. We set it to 3, the tracker will do it every 3 frames, and so on. So the best thing is to leave it default, 1 frame per point. Here in adaptive mode, we have 3 options, none, every frame, and best match. But don't worry about it too much, just leave it at none and you'll be fine. Here on path center, we've got 2 options, pattern center and track center append. And I'll get to that in a minute, but before that, let's make a quick track so we can see how it works. So our tracker is set, our properties are set, and now let's track to end. Okay, I hit stop because that's enough. So let's go back to the beginning and let's stick some text to it. Let's type it. And let's connect our text to our tracker. And we can't see anything. And to fix that, we have to select our tracker, come to operation, and here in operation again, we change it from none to match move. And make sure the merge option is set to foreground over background. And now our text is visible. So let's take our text close to our tracker, right here. Now let's see how it goes. Now, as you can see, it worked perfectly until the text got to the edge of the frame. So now there are 2 ways we can go about this. Let's select our tracker. So here's where the path center comes in handy. If we leave it at pattern center, we can go back to the frame where it starts to get wobbly, right here, and we can reset our tracker to another point in the frame. Let's say right here. Let's disconnect our text and let's track from this point forward. Okay, let's go back. Let's reconnect our text. Now let's see what happens. You got it? This option makes our text follow along the center of the new pattern. But let's say we want to make the text follow along the clip and get out of frame. In this case, what do we do? Well, let's go back to the wobbly point. Here is fine. And we're gonna change the path center from pattern center to track center append. Now we're gonna zoom in our screen. And at this point, we'll reset our tracker to a point close to our original tracking point. Let's say right here. Now let's track forward. And do you see what it did? The tracker took this last piece of motion and added it to our original pattern. Let's go back to the beginning and let's see how it goes. And the text is gone. And that's how you use the point tracker inside DaVinci Resolve. And if you like this video, make sure to subscribe to the channel and let me know in the comments below what types of videos you want me to make. And if you want to learn how to use the planner tracker inside DaVinci Resolve, make sure to check out this video showing on your screen right now, and I'll see you there.